a 5-pound bag of the mushroom mycelium, that you'd want to inoculate a space that's about 4 feet by 4 feet, kind of a square. So that could be in a garden bed, it could just be on the forest floor, really anywhere that suits you. And again, keep in mind that if you have a dry year, you might want to keep it in a place that you would water anyway, so that you could water your mushrooms. So what I usually do is just a few flags, just sort of pace out that space. So maybe 4, doesn't have to be perfect. It seems like the mushrooms enjoy growing most between the ground layer and the duff. So we want to get them established there, and eventually they'll move through, but it's probably they're accessing the moisture in there, and also they tend to want to be part of the soil biology. So I think if you have them too far away from that moist soil level, then they're not going to do as well. So we'll move that aside because we're gonna actually put that back at the end. Our materials are really just 2 buckets of hardwood sawdust. So this is oak sawdust from a local furniture maker. And then a few buckets of mixed hardwood wood chips. This is mostly oak and maple and some others. And then, of course, your spawn as well. So we'll start with the sawdust. We'll just about an inch or so is good. So we'll just spread this out. So after your sawdust layer, then you're going to add your mushrooms. And this is, again, a 5-pound bag of Stropharia spawn. So that's basically been grown in a laboratory in a sterile environment on sawdust. And once we open this bag, which has a little like breathable patch on it, once we open the bag, it's no longer sterile, but putting it in this environment's fine. And Stropharia is actually, out of all the mushrooms, the most tolerant of other species. So we don't have to worry too much about keeping it just in Stropharia. Other things are okay. So open this up. And so you can see here, this is all colonized with that white mycelium. And basically we just try to sprinkle it as finely as we can through the sawdust. Literature says you can inoculate a bed up to 3 or 4 times this size with a 5-pound block. But we like to see people succeed. So if you have a smaller success in this area, it'll likely spread to other parts, or you can, again, you can harvest some and actually move it once it's growing well. So better to start smaller and over inoculate and have it work. Last step, we'll add our wood chips. So the minimum would be maybe about 2 inches. You could go as deep as 4 inches. Again, as your Stropharia eats through these, this is really its food. So first it'll grow through the sawdust, and then it'll grow through the wood chips. And as it grows through the wood chips, it'll actually break this material down. So it's actually really nice for a soil building mechanism to have the mushrooms eat through this fruit, give you some mushrooms, and also build your soil at the same time. But what you need to be careful of, especially as winter is coming on, is to keep a fresh layer of chips on top of this. Because if the Stropharia is right on top, it may die in the cold winter temperatures. So you could add maybe a couple inches of fresh chips just before winter starts, and you'll be fine and good to go. Stropharia, and it's very noticeable, this like kind of large, thready white masses. on there. And again, some of the good sign that it's doing well is like it's like actually fused these wood chips together into a cluster, and that's kind of throughout all this material is a lot of wood chips completely covered in the mycelium, and sort of the presence of it throughout all of this duff layer here.